I wish I could share all the love that's in my heart. Remove.
Hello, Mount Vernon. Welcome back to Conversations with Dr. Kim. We've had a wonderful beginning to the year, and our academic initiatives are just starting. We have a firm belief that all scholars can learn, and to do this, we have to get back to basics and make learning fun. Today, I have invited two special guests to discuss what that means for scholars and their family. Dr. Beverly Jones, Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Curriculum and Instruction and School Improvement, and Dr. Jamal Doggett, Assistant Superintendent for Elementary Curriculum and Instruction and Administration, will be here to lead the way on our curriculum instruction and teaching methods, and they are here to explain exactly why our new approach will be successful. Good afternoon, Dr. Doggett. How are you today?
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me back.
Please tell the Mount Vernon family a little bit about yourself and include your new role within the district.
Well, Dr. Jamal Doggett, born and raised in Mount Vernon. This is my 24th year in the Mount Vernon City School District. I've done 6 years as a teacher, 6 years as an assistant principal, 10 years as a principal, and this is my second year as an assistant superintendent. My title has changed this year. I'm the assistant superintendent of elementary curriculum instruction and administration, which means I'll be responsible for the K-6 level. I'll be responsible for No Place for Hate, PBIS, RTI, the teachers and principals, APPR, and whatever else is necessary.
Thank you for that. Hi, Dr. Jones. How are you today?
I am doing great, Dr. Smith. Thanks for having me.
I'm so glad you was able to join us. Could you tell us a little bit about yourself and also explain your new role here within the district?
Great. My name is Dr. Beverly Jones. I'm the Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Curriculum and Instruction and School Improvement. I have been a part of the Mount Vernon City School District since 2000. I taught Math 8 and Algebra 1 from 2000 to 2010. I am back in the district as the Assistant Superintendent since August of last year. In my new role, I'm working closely with the secondary schools. I'm in charge of grades 7 through 12. In my new role as Assistant Superintendent of Secondary Curriculum and Instruction and School Improvement, I intend to work with closely with secondary principals to improve the graduation rate and to make sure that students are getting exactly what they need. We have instituted several new pathways which will enhance our graduation rate. And I know this is at the end, but it's certainly the most important part. So I'm working to make sure that students are getting the academics that they need to be successful for graduation and beyond.
Thank you, Dr. Jones. Dr. Doggett, could you tell us why we're wearing blue today?
I just thought we was wearing blue just because. This month is National Bullying Prevention Month, so we decided as a district to take a united stance against bullying, so the whole entire district is wearing blue shirts. This is one of three initiatives that the district is doing to promote Anti-Bullying Month. We're doing something on October 12th, which is our No Place for Hate kickoff, and on October 19th, we'll be wearing orange for Unity Day. So the whole district and community is wearing blue as we take a united stance against bullying. That's why we all have on blue today.
That's a wonderful thing. Because, you know, we can't allow bullying in our schools, and our students have to be safe. And as I continue to say, safety is one of my top priorities. Okay, Mr. Doggett, this school year has gotten off to a good start. What magical things happen here in Mount Vernon. Could you please share some exciting news?
Okay, we have several exciting news and initiatives that actually occurred this year. We were able to revamp our literacy rollout for grades K-8. We are basically adding the science of reading, components of the balance of literacy, and components of structured literacy all into one literacy rollout this year. We have class libraries that are culturally diverse. They focus on Black and Latino boys and girls in STEM. That's exciting. We continue with our foundations, which is our multi-sensory approach to phonemic awareness and phonics. We have adapted a portion for our math program of the Ready Classroom, because this is the year that we were supposed to adopt a new math program, but we decided not to adopt. We're going to pilot for grades K-8 this year. It's basically an extension of the iReady platform that we already have. We have our RTI and our PBIS, which is now combined into one umbrella, which is called the Multi-Tiered System of Support. We continue with our No Place for Hate initiative. This is the first year that on the K-6 level, that the directors will be providing professional development on the 5 first curriculum meetings for the staff. So we have some exciting things going on this year.
That's wonderful. Sounds like we're really on the move, Mr. Doggett.
Yes.
I said Mr., it's Dr. Doggett. Please forgive me.
Sure.
Dr. Jones, what exciting news do you have for us?
Oh, so just to continue just to add to Dr. Doggett's response just now, we have 4 newly hired math specialists that's going to help with the work that he just mentioned. We also cannot do this work in literacy without our 39 reading specialists. And to get everybody up to speed, to be data-driven, we have looked at our professional developments for this year. We're making sure that teachers understand what the research is saying about how students learn. We're making specific efforts to teach students how to learn. We're making specific effort to make sure teachers understand what they are to teach, to build their capacity so that our students can be the benefactors.
Thank you. Dr. Jones, could you also tell us what the secret sauce is?
I firmly believe that teachers are the secret sauce.
Oh, okay.
And here's why. Teachers are the closest to our scholars. They are in their classrooms with our scholars every single day. They know more about our scholars than we do. So supporting teachers so they can be the secret sauce to help students overcome all the academic difficulties and to fill in those academic gaps. When we empower our teachers, when we invest in our teachers, we end up seeing the results. We end up seeing students' improved outcomes.
Thank you so very much.
You're welcome.
Okay, so, Dr. Doggett,
yes.
Why are we going back to basics?
Less is more, first of all, and we're going back to what we know that works. We're going back to the basics. We're going back to phonics. We're going back to fluency. We're going back to repetition. All the research-based strategies that worked. They're very simple.
Okay, yes.
I can also say that back to basics allows for opportunities for teachers to take risks in their instructional practices as well.
Thank you for that. Dr. Jones, what can we expect going forward regarding back to basics?
Okay, so I mentioned quality professional PD. I mentioned quality resources that's going to create the impact that we need. Dr. Doggett spoke about going back to basics in the area, in those research-based areas that we need to. I believe we need to do that because our scholars have been working below expectations for some time and continuing to do the same thing the same way over and over equates to insanity. So for us to make a difference, we have to make some changes. So we are looking at focusing on the concrete, making sure that students can feel, touch, see, smell in any content area, exposing them to the concrete first before we build onto the pictorial, onto the abstract. So going back to basic means that we are going to look at how students learn and provide them and support them in the way they learn so that they can be a success.
Great. I want to piggyback on that. Could you tell us how we do all of that and make learning fun?
So once scholars are included in some decision making around what they are learning, once they are creating the learning experience, once they have opportunities to do the talking, because it is a very known statement that he who is doing the talking is doing the learning. So once we have provided them with opportunities to do classroom discourse and a different level where they are the makers of the learning opportunities, I believe that they're going to enjoy it. We are bringing in the manipulatives. We're bringing in everything that they need to create learning in a very fun way.
Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
What you will also find, just a piggyback on what Dr. Jones said, in all the curriculum subjects, you will find project-based learning. Mm-hmm. Where, like you said, you could touch, feel, learn by doing. And mm-hmm. that's very important. So we revamped all the curriculums to include literacy across the curriculum and project-based learning as well.
You know, Dr. Jones always stresses using manipulatives. And I find that fascinating and very interesting. How do we incorporate that in our classrooms?
So as mentioned before, there is manipulatives for every single content area. I've been a math director for over 17 years, and I've also been a math teacher for the better part of my career. And once I place in front of students those blocks or those counters, it provides a deeper understanding for the students. If they can pull it apart, similar in science, if I have a frog, for example, that they can pull apart and pull out the heart and put the heart back in its place, it's going to make learning fun for them. So I am a big believer in providing students with every new concept you're introducing, providing those opportunities that they can see and feel and make meaning of the learning that's placed before them.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Dr. Doggett, what support will be provided to staff to get back to basics?
Oh, we have a lot of support this year. As we both mentioned, we have a strong PD plan this year, so we provide a professional development on superintendent conference days and our curriculum meeting days as well. Our directors will be working directly with the teachers and principals. Principals also will be working directly with their staff to provide the support. We laid out the expectations to the community in September, and basically those expectations will be followed up through the schools. So there's a lot of support for the teachers. But we really want them to take risks, have fun, and get back to basics. And like Dr. Jones said, use those manipulatives in all content areas. We really focus more on the build it, draw it, write it. So you build it, you draw it, you talk about it, and at the end you make meaning of it, and that's where you do the writing. So we want to make sure that we incorporate it. We keep it a simple formula.
Thank you. Dr. Jones, could you tell us what changes were made to the curriculum to support back to basics?
So taking a long look at the curriculum, my push is to get rid of all the fluffs. There are a lot of things, and at the last conference I attended, they talk about the kitchen sink curriculum, where you have everything thrown in. So taking a long look at the curriculum and make sure that they are standard aligned. Make sure that we are focusing on those priority standards, providing the resources that are going to drive these priority standards, and keep the focus on the focus. I think we have a little bit of a whole lot and not enough of any one thing. So in working with our teachers in our professional development and our curriculum Wednesdays, we are going to begin to see the difference. Helping teachers to understand the standards is a big thing. Once they understand their standards, and we all know the standards are like our GPS, they let us know where we're going and informed us as to when we have arrived. So once teachers understand those standards, they are going to do better at crafting great lesson plans that will focus on what's the focus.
Thank you. Dr. Doggett, how will the success of Back to Basics be measured?
Well, there's several ways that it can be measured. First, from a qualitative standpoint, it's basically teacher feedback. We can go around, ask the teachers, how's the curriculum being implemented, get verbal feedback. We can interview parents as well. We can interview principals and just get a a combination of qualitative information to see how it's going. Now on the qualitative side, the quantitative side, we can look at the data. Everything is going to be looked at by the data. We have common assessments that we can look at. We have beginning, mid-year, and end-of-year assessments that we can look at. I would also like to add, you know, student engagement. We can see how many students are more involved in lessons. We also can look at suspensions and attendance data to see if students are coming to school, if they're excited about that. And disruptive classroom incidents should go down if the students are engaged and learning is fun.
Thank you so much. Dr. Jones, what support will be provided to families to understand back to basics?
Great. So as we work together with our parent liaisons and our PTA council, we are very conscious that parents need of the things that parents need to understand. So in our Parents Resource Center, we're trying to, on a monthly basis, or as soon as, for example, the elementary schools are moving into a concept, we are providing those sessions in our Parent Resource Center to make sure parents understand what homework is going to look like. We're doing the same thing for our secondary as well. And so there will be numerous opportunities over the school year in our Parent Resource Center, in the activities that are put on in your your children's school by the parent liaison, and as well as in collaboration with the PTA. We will begin to educate our parents, to give them resources, help them practice with the resources so that they will understand when a student comes home and said, I have to do tape diagram today. They have an idea as to exactly what that is. So, and we are planning and working on what we call a parent university. It is in the making. It's not ready to roll out yet, but we are working on that.
Thank you so much. Dr. Doggett, what are your closing remarks?
Well, I'm about to say we're in a good space right now, but I would like to say to the Mount Vernon City School District that change takes time. We're in a three-step change process. Any change model, any change theory is usually about three steps. You have an initiation phase, an implementation phase, and a sustainability phase. We are currently in the initiation and implementing stages, which means we're getting the organization ready for the change, and we are also in the midst of change. So it's going to be uncomfortable. There's going to be trial and error. There's going to be confusion. There's going to be uncertainty with the rollouts that we're doing, but please stay the course. We need to go through that phase in order to get to the sustainability phase where all this now becomes natural and is embedded in the work that we're already doing. So please just be patient. We have a nice plan in place, and it's going to work.
Thank you for that. Dr. Jones, do you have any closing remarks?
Yes, I do. Parents, this is for you. We are working with our most prized possessions, and that is your children. And we want to see them do well. We could not do this without you. We understand that educating children is a partnership, one between the parents, the school, and the children, the students. So we intend to work this partnership, and we crave your support. We want to make sure that whatever decisions we made are inclusive. You will always be a part of. Make sure that when we reach out to you to be a part of certain decisions, you do not take it lightly, because your voices are needed. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Jones and Dr. Doggett. Thank you so very much for being here today. As you know, curriculum instruction is so very important. It's the meat and potato of our district. We want all our students to learn. We want to have a great year, and we're on our way to that. So I thank you so very much. We're going back to basics, and we're having a great year.